I wonder, what is a reptile? Oh, hi, I'm Kaden. Welcome to Smithsonian's National Zoo and Conservation Biology Institute, where I've been wondering, what makes a reptile? Let's go explore the zoo and find out. Come on. So what do you think? What is a reptile? Reptiles belong to a group of animals that have some of the same features. Can you think of different features that reptiles have? The first thing I always think of is scales. Reptiles have dry, scaly skin, and those scales are protection for them. Reptiles are also vertebrates, meaning they have backbones. If you feel up and down your back, that bone in the center, that's your backbone, so you're a vertebrate as well. Reptiles also lay eggs, though a few do give live birth. Reptiles breathe air, so they have lungs, just like we do. And reptiles are ectothermic, meaning they don't regulate their body temperature very well. So if they want to get warmer, they go hang out in the sun or get in warmer water. If they want to cool down, they'll go in the shade or cooler water. Now, thinking about those traits, can you think of any animals that might be reptiles? Let's go slither through the zoo and figure out some reptiles that we have. Come on, let's go. Here we have piranha. Now, we said that reptiles have scales and piranha have scales. Are they reptiles? What do you think? Well, remember we said reptiles have lungs, so that means they need to breathe air. Piranha use their gills to get oxygen through the water. So these are fish and not reptiles. Now here we have a Mata-Mata turtle. I see water, I see scales. Is this a reptile? Yes, it is. This turtle does have lungs. It doesn't breathe with its gills like fish. It will stick its head up, has actually a long nose. It'll stick it up out into the air to breathe. Now, can you think of any reptiles that don't have legs? Here we have a Smithsonian. A Smithsonian has a long body and no legs. Is it a reptile? Look close at its skin. Do you see scales? No, it has soft, moist skin. It lives underground or in the water. It is an amphibian. Can you think of a reptile that doesn't have any legs, like the Smithsonian? Are you thinking a snake? Here is a corn snake named Maisie. It's got a long, skinny body and no legs, but this snake doesn't need to stay moist like the Smithsonian. It has scales to help protect its skin. This is a great reptile with no legs. Now, can you think of a reptile with four legs? Here we have a California tiger salamander named Chip. Chip is brown, has some yellow spots. I see four legs and a tail. Is Chip a reptile? Well, if we look close, I do not see scales. I see soft, smooth skin. And I know Chip needs to stay wet all the time. Chip is an amphibian, not a reptile. So did you think of a reptile that has four legs? Okay. This animal has the same body shape as the salamander. I see four legs and a tail. Is it a reptile? This is a leopard gecko named Liam. It's yellow, white, brown spots. If we look close, this skin is not smooth and wet. This is bumpy. So this is a reptile because Liam has scales. He is a lizard. Now, can you think of any reptiles that might have hard shells? So how about this animal? This is a three-banded armadillo. It has a nice hard shell with scales. So is it a reptile? No, this isn't a reptile. Armadillos do have a wonderful shell for protection, but they are mammals. They are endothermic, meaning they can regulate their temperature. They have hair, give birth to live young, and feed their young with milk. So what type of reptile has a hard shell like an armadillo? Are you thinking turtle? You are correct. Here we have a star tortoise and an Aldabra tortoise. These are great turtles or reptiles with hard shells for protection. Turtles are my favorite reptile. What's your favorite reptile? Wow, that was a great question to explore and learn together. Reptiles have scales, lungs, and vertebrae. They include lizards, turtles, snakes, and even crocodiles. Now, some of these animals can sometimes seem scary. They can have sharp teeth or claws, and sometimes you might sneak up on them because they are so quiet. Now, it's okay to be a little scared, but remember, they are animals in their habitats just looking for food and water. Animals just like us. So if we see them, if we just watch them from a distance and leave them alone, they'll be fine and we won't scare them away and they will leave us alone. Well, thanks for joining and exploring with me. Do you have a question? If you do, ask your question and go find your answer. Go explore and learn more. Thanks for joining and I'll see you next time.